And on the neck muscles, when we are working near the face and near the hair, we don't use too much of the oil. Just enough so our hands will slide. Start with just holding the neck and the head, and then I'm going to shift the weight of my body to the back, and I'm going to just elongate the head and the neck. If you would imagine a rope, we'll do this kind of movement with the neck. It's going to be a very nice kind of feeling of pulling and releasing. I like to go underneath the shoulders, and I like to start feeling the muscles one by one. One of the biggest muscles here on the neck and shoulder is called trapezius, and it starts here at the bottom of the head from occiputus, and it goes all the way here to the shoulder. So why don't we just go ahead and work with this muscle? Feel the muscle fibers. It is also, trapezius is the one that is the most superficial one, so we'll warm up the first muscle first to be able to go to the deeper muscles. do the same on the other side. I'm going to be working again on all the muscles here on one side. I want to go to all the way to the lamina groove, which is the groove in between vertebrae. And I'm going to have like circular motion with my fingertips. Muscles in the neck, the muscles that are helping us to rotate our head to either side, and they are also helping us with the neck extension and flexion. And when we are here, we can focus on the neck muscles that are right here. They are called occipitals. It always feels so good to work on those attachments, especially by knowing that we hold all this tension in our neck. Neck muscle is one of the favorite moments of every massage. Sometimes we can even shift and use our tongue and try to get deeper to the suboccipital region. If there is so much tension, I can feel it. I'm going to do right now, I'm going to put my tongue very close to the spine, and I'm going to use the weight of the head to let the muscles just, so my tongue is going to sink in into the skin and muscles. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to put my fingers a very similar way, but instead of lifting head up, I'm going to just shift to the side. To do right now, I'm going to stretch the neck and I'm going to create number 8 with the neck. So that's concluding the neck muscles, the massage for neck muscles in the back. But we not only have the back on the muscles on the neck, we also have the front. And very often when we have problems and we are coughing, all the muscles right here on the neck, the front muscles are being affected. can finish the massage with neck stretch, very nice stretch of the neck would be just allowing the head to go towards one shoulder and just hold it and keep it for a few seconds. And we can do the same on the opposite side. Thank you so much for watching us today, and we'll see you next week. Thank you.